Hey, what's up? It's Jim, and I just got back from the new film, Captain America, The First Avenger. Steve Rogers, who is trying to get into the army any way he can, even though he is a very scrawny, small, asthmatic with lots of health problems, and they keep rejecting him until finally, a scientist played by Stanley Tucci takes him in and gives him a super serum in which he's transformed into Captain America. As this film chronicles Captain America's various adventures throughout World War II. I think there's a lot of influences of kind of more pulp fun World War II, Raiders of the Lost Ark. You can tell some Rocketeer stuff, but that's because of the same director. And I also noticed some Fleischer Superman, and I think that really worked for the aesthetic of the film, and it gave it kind of a unique look rather than just being a generic superhero movie that takes place in 2011. Like Thor, this movie has kind of a time and a place and a setting, 30 Seconds to Tokyo kind of movie infused with, you know, a superhero movie. At the same time, this is kind of a prequel. I mean, obviously it's a prequel to the Avengers, but you can very much tell with the World's Fair type thing that Tony Stark's dad is in, which is much like the Expo in Iron Man 2. My only major complaint with Captain America, unlike Thor or Iron Man, which are kind of small, just little stories, this is a very big story. Captain America's entire experience throughout World War II. And I would actually like to see two or three Captain America World War II movies instead of this kind of cliff note summary kind of movie of what happened in the comic books. It probably might have been a lot stronger if it had been more of a smaller story instead of trying to cover all this ground. I think it did it very well, which a lot of comic book movies try to cover way too much ground than they're really capable of. They're just pushing in too much material. And this film, although it does push in too much material, doesn't feel like that. Chris Evans, I never liked Chris Evans before this. You know, I saw him in The Losers more recently, and I was like, I don't like him in that. I didn't like him in Fantastic Four. I just did not get why people even really liked Chris Evans. But in this film, I thought he did a really good job. He got kind of how lame Captain America is, how honest he is, how much of a do-gooder he is. He got all that really well without making him, you know, kind of a caricature or a joke. Hugo Weaving did a great job as Red Skull. He based his performance in the Red Skull a little bit on Herzog, which I could kind of tell, which I thought was really funny. It kind of reminds me of how comic booky something like X-Men First Class was. I've noticed in comic book movies is that we're making them look more like comic books. With Thor, with Iron Man, with X-Men First Class, with Kick-Ass, with this film, is that they make it look like it was a comic book. Like, you absolutely know at some point this was a comic book. I think that really helps Captain America. This is one of my more favorite blockbuster films I've seen this year. I'm not as ecstatic about it as X-Men First Class. It's a fun Hollywood movie. The only Marvel movies I think that are better than Captain America, The First Avenger, is X-Men 2, X-Men First Class, Iron Man, and Spider-Man 2. Those are the only ones I think I'd probably rank higher than. Yes. So if you have seen Captain America, The First Avenger, then comment below in the comments. And subscribe if you would like to. I liked it. I saw it with my wife and she did not like it, but I liked it a lot. I got really into it.